Secretary Rio, April Fool's Day has come and gone, but the effects are still being felt in the cyber community because of the work of this black hat hacker group called Pinoy Lulsec. Yes. Pinoy Lulsec claims they actually exfiltrated data from the Armed Forces database, which exposed the name, serial numbers, and other personal information of some of the soldiers. Yes. I don't know how many accounts exactly.
20,000.
20,000?
Yeah. Hmm. Philippine Army mostly.
Yeah. I'm sure that hits close to home because you're a retired general. So how vulnerable are government websites, especially those of the armed forces?
Well, in this particular exercise, it seems that only the armed forces and some two or three schools were really hacked. The armed forces came up with a statement, I think this afternoon, that what was really breached was old data, that are supposed to be no longer, that has no value anymore in terms of information. No? And
so it's an old database.
Yes, it's an old database that was breached. No? Mm. So most of those who are there have already been retired or no longer with the service, and therefore, but of course that does not really answer the concern that why, even if it's a server that is containing all data, that still has to be protected. No? Mm-hmm. It should not be a subject of cyber crime or cyber attack. We are still investigating this. We have contacted G6, that is the who has the responsibility in what we call a communication electronic information system of the Army.
And you used to work there, right? You used to work at
G6. Yes,
when
I was
your
there,
old unit.
It was still G11, and then in the Army, I was G11. Then when I was brought to the JetSQ, it became J11. No? Yeah. But now it's 6.
Called no? G6. Yeah.
We eliminated most of our staff, and from 11, it became 6, J6.
So if the military is saying it's an old database, but then again, of course, you're saying that whether that's the case, it should still have been adequately protected.
Yes.
Can you say, at least now, that the military's database and other government databases still need to be reinforced in terms of cybersecurity?
Oh, yes, definitely. The DICT, we have our data center, and we host 170 government agencies website, and so far none of them have been hacked. No, the armed forces have their own their data center is outside of our responsibility. No, and we are still awaiting for the formal investigation. What exactly happened? The National Privacy Commission is also into it because private data has been breached or leaked out. And hopefully by next week, we will have some answers and solutions on how this should not happen again.
Every April Fool's Day.
Every April Fool's Day, yes.
Is the DICT interested in pressing charges against this group? This is Pinoy Lulsec, which is supposed to be the Philippine version of the international Lulsec. Are officials interested in pressing charges against them?
Yes, actually now, since this is considered cybercrime, it is now in the purview of our law enforcement agencies, no? The NBI and the PNP, Cyber Crime Divisions. No? We actually in DICT, we take care of cybersecurity as a whole. And cybersecurity is actually the prevention of cybercrime. No? The more effective your cybersecurity is, then the less cybercrime will be
can take place.
Taking place. No? It's just like you secure your home, you put padlocks.
So prevention more than cure.
So that is a, but once a breach is occurred, then it becomes a law enforcement concern. No?
Okay.
We have, the ICT has chair of what we call cyber crime investigation coordinating center. No?
That's Alan so, Cabanlong's territory.
So cybercrime is still under our purview, but here we act as the coordinating body, so that there will be a focus on the investigation of its cybercrime cases. No?
So are you going after them? Are you interested finding out who these people are?
Yes, in fact, this is one very important measure, no? Catching them. Yes, because if
catch you cannot
if you catch
can.
Them, then it will, they can always, knowing that they could not be caught or it's difficult for us to catch them, they will always do this.
Is it possible to catch them?
Oh, yes. Both NBI and the PNP have already forensic capabilities, no? These are things that are analytical in nature. And of course, the PNP and the NBI have already coordinative functions with other cyber crime agencies. No?
Yeah.
So most of these, except for the Pinoy, are outside of our countries. Yeah. No?